but you can do it. You can do it. Just do it. And I'm like, nah, bro. And he's like, let go, bro. And I'm like, but I can't let go, bro. My name is Slowthai, TYRON Frampton, and I'm from Northampton. But the type of music I make, or how I describe it, is just whatever I'm feeling. Whatever you feel inside, that's what it is. It's like energy, it's the calm, it's just a vibe. When I make music, I don't really think about what it is. I believe like punk and that stuff's an attitude or an energy, but I don't try to think about what I'm doing too much. I'd rather just feel it. But what I want to accomplish with this album is just like connect, showing people they're not alone, and like helping people with their mental health, because I know I needed it with mine. So it's just about opening eyes and letting people know it's okay to be themselves no matter how it is. TYRON is going to be a personal album. It's going to be my like introspective thought, how I feel about myself. And being that there's I believe we all make contradictions through growing up and changing and evolving, so like it was just me just being as honest as I can, facing up to things and like breaking down any stereotypes that people have of me. With like all the controversy and stuff that surrounds me or I've been involved in, I feel like it definitely shifts your mindset into a way where it is not harder to make music, but what is kind of driving you changes. So I know I'm taking the steps to better myself, so it's just about not getting too carried away with feeling pissed off with how people perceive me. It's about, all right, they don't understand, so I gotta show them how, like I gotta teach them more about myself or show them a deeper level. So it definitely made me more angry for a time. So we cancelled. The aim was that just a fuck you to everyone that tried to rub my name through the dirt, innit?
I am a Maxar, fuck the Oscars. Main stage in my boxes. 1,000 grams, fuck the Grammys. Same for the shotters.
People are like cancelling people over eating dairy and shit, you know what I mean? Like it's like, or them contradicting one of their views or beliefs from before. So, like, we're human, we make mistakes. We can't just crucify someone because of one mistake they made. You need to like teach them or allow them time to learn themselves and then like make a decision from that.
Cancel me, 20 awards on the mantelpiece, pyramid stage at Glastonbury, girls in the crowd got their hands on me.
Skip's like a big brother to me, he looks out for me, he has my best interests at heart, and he's like guided and mentored me in ways. Like just linking up, I linked up with him, I was having a bad trip, we could see I was going through it as a friend, and then like he just pulled me out of that dark place and then we made the song. It's like pretty straightforward. You just, that's what you do. That's what you do for your brothers, isn't it? Like if one of you's down, you pick them up and you make sure you empower them. You don't let them just wallow in turmoil or the darkness. You try and bring them to the light. But film for me is so important. It's like, I watch so many films, I watch so much TV, well not normal TV, just like series, I watch so many documentaries, and like I just like shots, I like referencing them, I like seeing the trickery of the camera, how people do certain things, how like I want to understand how, like what their thought process is behind it, like Hitchcock, the pulling out and zooming in so it creates the effect where you get bigger but you're further away. Just all these things, that it's a different art form and I definitely appreciate it and value it. And I think a lot of movies are metaphors for other things. So it's just, as someone who's a visual artist, like with my music, I think it's key to utilizing metaphors or things that have stood out to me. So I suppose it's important, but at the same time, it is what it is. It's just what I love, innit? I love music, I love film. I'm trying time together as best as I can. And yeah, they're like, when you love something, you might as well do it as much as you can, innit?
We don't go on dates, we went our separate ways, and we don't conversate.
This was kind of the thing that started, like, oh, I want to make an album. And Feel Away started basically me and Dom from Mount Kimbie going through samples, and it was samples of James. There's samples they'd recorded together, and Dom had just chopped up. And then we got to the sample of Feel Away, and I was like, we must have made like four other songs or something that day. And I was like, as soon as I heard it, I was like, boom, this one's the one. And it was like, kept looking for more, going through. And I was like, nah, that one's the one. Go back to that one, go back to that one. So we put it in. I laid it real quick, like the bit I had. And then I was like, you know what? James would be perfect on this. And he was like, yeah, I'll send it to him. So, because he was in New York at the point in time, and we was in LA, it was like, had to wait. And in my head, I was just like, oh, he ain't gonna do nothing. And then literally the next day, like when I was speaking to him the other day, he said, as soon as he got it, he had it done. Like in 5 minutes, he knew what he wanted to say.
This time I'll have one hand free. This has nothing to do with me.
The intention of the song was kinda from previous experience and trauma, and paying it homage to my brother with this, because he passed away when he was a baby, so there's definitely parts of it that connected with me and invoked more of that emotion, be it that I felt certain things because of his passing. But it just seemed right to be like a role reversal about all them things. It seemed perfect to have to dedicate it to my little brother. Like my little brother, I believe he's with me everywhere I go, like looking over me. So I need to just do more to show that I, like how much he means to me, innit? And then working on something that's personal with James and Dom. It's like when you become friends with people, it's not hard to open up. Like I've always been someone who's tried to open up as best I can. There's times when there's definitely things I hold back. But like when it's people that you consider so close to your heart, you gotta be open with them. And anyone who's a good producer or a good friend, they'll be willing to listen and like try and help you or understand at least. Mazayin is a mad, it means mad thing, it means like madness, like. It's like, how is this situation that mad? Or how is life this mad? Like, and madness can be anything. It can be like positive, it can be a negative thing. Like, that's a madness. Like, how could someone do that to someone else? Or that's a madness. Like, that's sick. That, how is it this good? And like, I don't know. That's just something me and my friends use. Like, some people will just say Maza. Some people will say Mazaleen. What I was trying to get across with Maza is just like the experiences I've had in life and how at different points in my life, like I might have relied on drugs to enhance my feelings, or I felt like without them, I wouldn't feel certain things, or I wouldn't connect, or I wouldn't feel love. Or I remember when I was growing up, there was like a period in my life, I literally didn't feel anything, you know what I mean? Like I didn't care about anybody, I didn't connect with anybody, I just didn't give a fuck. And then like through doing stuff and experiencing life and the madness that it's given me and the opportunities and being in these surroundings and seeing these people or linking up, it kind of opened my eyes. And then there's like a point where it all come crashing down, not feeling stuff for so long. Then eventually when you feel something, it's overwhelming. So it's a madness, isn't it? It's a mazayin, like. One of the first shows I'd done in LA, but I didn't know he'd been, like I spoke to him yesterday and he'd been lying in, like in the background for so long, like coming and watching. Apparently he'd been to shows and just been in the crowd, just observing. And then from that, he just come and just give me love, man. Like, dabbed me up and said, yo, bro, you're hard. And then from that,
ring, ring, that's a smartphone. Beep, beep, do your heart go. Slow tie, hear your part go.
We got a bunch of songs that we recorded together that we'd probably have a million more songs if it wasn't for COVID, you know what I mean? Like when we recorded Mazza, I recorded my bit in Northampton. When we made the beat, I recorded my bit, and then he was in London, so I called him. He was like, come through. Went and linked him, played him the thing, he jumped straight on it. No questions asked, no nothing. He done like 7 different versions or something crazy. He done so many different verses, because he just goes straight off the top. He's like, bam, 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 bam. Like, watching him work, because I write, I can't do it. Like, I tried with him, and he's like, come on, you gotta go faster. And I'm like, bro, it's not working. Like, I don't do it like this, bro. And he's like, but you can do it, you can do it, just do it. And I'm like, nah, bro. And he's like, let go, bro. And I'm like, but I can't let go, bro. Just like that. Like, it's one of them, when you're bridges with someone, you can kind of poke and prod each other till you get what you want out, like the best out of them, you know what I'm saying? I don't know, making music with people and linking up with people and then going and seeing them perform and them having people sing along to their music, that's the best feeling, man. Watching people grow, watching people channel their energies, that, like, it's like a proud moment, especially if you're part of it. It makes you even prouder, so. For me, this album, the aim of it is to help people know they're not alone with feeling things and help people with their mental health and let them know that no matter where you are, no matter how good things are going, they can just switch and be bad, and just help them in any way. I hope this album helps people as much as it helped me, and I just want the world to hear it, man. I appreciate everyone. I appreciate everyone's support and love, and I appreciate you for your time. And lots of love. Thank you.